Instagram where the movie started. Facing at a photo they've taken. Space street flying through the skies and petals happen everywhere.
What's up guys, my name is Aman and you're watching Electrical Infinity. In this video, I'm gonna explain you about electrical designing of a high-rise building. In other words, designing of G+10. First of all, we need to go through some basics and standards before starting designing steps. Here in our case, which is G+10, G means ground and 10 means number of floor, which has multiple number of 2 BHK, 3 BHK and 4 BHK flats, whereas BHK stands for bedroom, hall and kitchen. And the energy meters we use for these flats have some standards according to government. For 2 BHK flats, we use 5 kilowatt energy meter. And for 3 BHK, we use 7.5 kilowatt energy meter, whereas for 4 BHK, we use 10 kilowatt energy meter. In addition to this, for villas, we use 10 kilowatt energy meter for 3 BHK, and for 4 BHK, we use 15 kilowatt of energy meter. Now let's start working on the main idea of this video, which has 5 steps. The first one is total connected load, second one is transformer sizing, and third one is circuit breaker sizing for transformer. The main difference between designing of normal building and high-rise building lies in step 4 and 5, which I will discuss later. So our fourth step is circuit breaker sizing for main meter panel and load, whereas our fifth and last step is single line diagram. Focusing on first step, which is calculation of total connected load of the building, which is equals to common load plus flat load. Common load of building has different varieties of load except flat load, that is lift, borewell pump, water pump and lighting. In our case, we are using 3 lifts each of 10 HP, 2 borewell pumps each of 5 HP, 4 water pumps each of 5 HP and 20 kilowatt of total lighting load for parking, lobby and staircase area. In order to convert this load, which is in HP, to kilowatt, we need to multiply it with value 0.746. So in our case, we are using 3 lifts each of 10 HP. So 10 into 0.746 into 3 gives us a value of lift load in kilowatt. So 10 into 0.746 into 3 is equals to 22.38 kilowatt. Whereas for borewell pump, we know that we are using 2 pumps each of 5 HP. So 5 into 0.746 into 2 gives us a value 7.46 kilowatt. Similarly, for water pump, we get value as 14.92 kilowatt, and we know that the total value of lighting is 20 kilowatt. This gives us a total common load of 64.76 kilowatt. Now we are required to calculate flat load in order to get total connected load. Let us suppose we have 4 2 BHK flats on each floor, which is in total 40 flats on 10 floors. Similarly, 3 3 BHK flats on each floor, which is in total 30 flats on 10 floors. And 3 4 BHK on each floor, which is also 30 flats on 10 floors respectively. After this, we have to calculate total load of each flat. For 2 BHK flat, we use 5 kilowatt energy meter, as I told you earlier. So 5 kilowatt energy meter multiplied by number of flats on floor, which is 4, and number of floors, which is 10. So 5 into 4 into 10 give us a value of 200 kilowatt. Similarly, for 3 BHK, as I told you earlier, we use 7.5 kilowatt energy meter. So 7.5 into number of flats, which is 3, into number of floors, which is 10, give us a value 225 kilowatt. And lastly, for 4 BHK flats, we use 10 kilowatt energy meter. So 10 kilowatt into number of flats, which is 3, and number of floors, which is 10, give us a value of 300 kilowatt. So the total connected load is equals to common load plus flat load. So our common load value is 64.76. So 64.76 is our common load value, plus we have to add the 2 BHK, 3 BHK and 4 BHK load, which is 200, 225 and 300. This gives us a value of 790 kilowatt, which is total common load of this building. So the first step is done. Now we have to move to the second step. Before jumping into second step, we need to calculate peak demand. In order to calculate peak demand, we need to consider demand factor, which is given by peak demand divided by total connected load. So according to Indian standards, our demand factor is 60% for residential and 80 to 90% for commercial. and for industry our demand factor is 90%, whereas in Gulf the demand factor is 90% for residential and commercial, and for industry is 125%. So here we are considering demand factor as 70%, substituting the values of demand factor and total connected load, which is 790. So we get the value of peak demand as 0.7 into 790, that gives us a value of 553 kilowatt. Now moving on to second step, which is transformer sizing. We know that peak demand is equals to 553 kilowatt. The formula for KVA is equals to kilowatt divided by power factor. So substituting the values 533 and 0.8 as power factor, we get the value of 691.25 KVA. That's equals to 692 KVA. So here is the standard sizes of the transformer. You can see here. So as you see here, I consider 800 KVA transformer for our building. So this one is recommended. So the third step is circuit breaker sizing of the transformer. So in order to calculate this, we need to consider multiplying factor kilowatt to ampere and KVA to ampere. So in order to convert KVA to ampere, we have to multiply by 1.4. to kilowatt to ampere, we need to multiply by 1.9, and for HP to ampere, we need to multiply by 1.5. so 800 into 1.4 give us a value of 1120. So the circuit breaker we are using here is, according to standard sizes, is 1250 ampere ACB is recommended. You can watch the video by clicking on the top right side about ampere conversions. And we are done with the first, second and third step. Now we have to jump to the main portion of our video, which is fourth and fifth step. Our last second step is circuit breaker sizing for main meter panel and flats. Here we have to make a note that for each panel we can use maximum of 30 energy meter. We are dividing this building into four parts in order to get maximum of 30 energy meter in each panel. So we are considering here four panels, which is cellar 1, cellar 2, ground floor and first floor for panel 1, 2, 3, 4 for panel 2, 5, 6, 7 for panel 3 and 8, 9, 10 for panel 4. In order to select the panel 1 MCB or circuit breaker, we need to calculate its total load first. So panel 1 has one floor and common load, which is first floor and common load, which has 10 flats in first floor. So that is 2 BHK 4 flats, 3 BHK 3 flats and 4 BHK 3 flats. As I have shown you earlier, for 2 BHK we use 5 kilowatt energy meter. So 4 into 5 kilowatt, which gives us a value 20 kilowatt. Similarly for 3 BHK 7.5 kilowatt energy meter, so 3 into 7.5, and for 4 BHK 10 kilowatt energy meter, 3 into 10, which is 30 kilowatt. So our common load here is 60 kilowatt as we have calculated earlier. So the total value we get is 137.5 kilowatt of panel 1 load. After this, we need to consider demand factor, which is 70%. So total connected load is equals to 138 into 0.7. That gives us a value of 97 kilowatt. So converting this 97 kilowatt to ampere, we get a value of circuit breaker ampere as 185. And the circuit breaker we are using here is 250 ampere triple pole MCCB for panel 1. Additionally, we need to select circuit breakers for panel 2, 3 and 4. In order to do this, we need to calculate loads. So each floor has 10 flats, which means 10 energy meters. So 3 floors means 30 energy meters on each panel. So on each floor, we have 4 flats, right? 2 BHK 4, 3 BHK 3 and 4 BHK 3. So for 2 BHK, we know that we are using 4 flats. So 4 into energy meter, which is 5 kilowatt, into number of floors, which is 3. Similarly for 3 BHK, we know that we are using 3 flats and 7.5 into 3, which is floor. And for 4 BHK, we know that we are using 3 flats, 10 kilowatt energy meter for 3 floors. Thus, calculating the value of 2 BHK, we get a value 60 kilowatt, load of 3 BHK as 67.5 for 3 floors, and load of 4 BHK for 3 floors is 90 kilowatt. Thus, the total connected load for 3 floors is 217.5 kilowatt, considering demand factor, which is 70%. Total connected load is equals to 218 kilowatt into 0.7. That gives us a value of 152.6 kilowatt. Converting this to ampere, we know that 1.9 is the multiplication factor for kilowatt to ampere. So 153 into 1.9 ampere is equals to 290.7, which is 291 ampere. So selecting here circuit breaker according to the standard sizes, So our ampere is 291. Jumping to the standard size chart, we can see here the recommended size is 400 ampere MCCB. So I'm selecting here 400 ampere MCCB triple pole for panel 2. Since the load is same for panel 3 and 4, we are using 400 ampere MCCB triple pole for panel 3 and 4 too. Thus, we have calculated the circuit breaker sizing for 1, 2, 3 and 4 panel, which is 400 ampere MCCB for panel 2, 3 and 4, whereas for panel 1, we are using 250 ampere. So each floor we are having 30 energy meter. On panel 2, we have 30 energy meter, panel 3, we have 30 energy meter, each floor has 10 energy meter, similarly panel 4 has 30 energy meter. And panel 1 has 10 energy meter for first floor and 1 energy meter for common load, which is in total 11 energy meter. Thus we are done with the circuit breaker sizing of each panel. Now we have to calculate circuit breaker sizing of each load for 2 BHK, 3 BHK and 4 BHK flats. So for 2 BHK, we have to consider a safety factor, which is 2. So 5 kilowatt, which is energy meter, into 1.9, which is conversion multiplying factor, into safety factor, which gives us a value of 19 ampere. So 40 ampere 4 pole MCCB is selected. And the same story is for 3 BHK, which is 7.5 energy meter into 1.9 into 2, therefore 50 ampere 4 pole MCB is recommended. Similarly for 4 BHK, 10 kilowatt energy meter into 1.9 into 2 is equals to 38, so 63 ampere MCB is recommended for this. The common load for this is, as we know, that 65 kilowatt, 65 into 1.9 into 2 into 0.7, which is demand factor. So this, we get a value of 173 kilowatt for common load. Therefore 200 ampere MCCB triple pole is recommended for common load. So we have calculated the load and circuit breaker for 2 BHK, 3 BHK, 4 BHK and common load individually. And now we have to move to the last step, which is single line diagram. We are done with first, second, third and fourth step. Now it's time for fifth and final step of our video. Overall, going through revision, we calculated common load for lift, borewell pump and various load and got the value as 64.76 kilowatt, and also we calculated flat load for each floor and the total connected load we got as 790 kilowatt. After that, we did a transformer sizing using the formula KVA is equals to kilowatt by power factor. We considered a peak demand here, so our transformer was 800 kVA. After that, we calculated the circuit breaker sizing for transformer, which is 1250 ampere ACB for this transformer, and you can check the conversion video here by clicking on the link above here. And therefore after that, we have calculated the circuit breaker and loads for each panel. Here you can see we got 250 ampere for panel 1 and 400 ampere for panel 2, similarly for panel 3 and 4. And also we calculated circuit breaker sizing for each load for 2 BHK, 3 BHK, 4 BHK and common load. Thus we are done with all the four steps here. Now moving to the final and most important step of our video. In this, we are using a 11 kV Y440 transformer, which is a dry type, as we use dry type transformer for indoor. This is 800 kVA transformer, as we have calculated the value earlier. So 800 kVA dry type indoor transformer on the SLD. So here I am drawing the four lines, which is R, Y, B and N. After placing transformer here, I'm using a 1250 ampere ACB, which is triple pole, as we have calculated earlier. So this is 1250 ampere triple pole ACB. Now I'm drawing main LT panel for panel 1, 2, 3 and 4. Panel 1 is for common load and first floor. So we are using here 250 ampere MCCB triple pole, and for panel 2, 3 and 4, I am using 400 ampere MCCB triple pole, as I have calculated earlier. So this is the main LT panel, which is 4 MCCB for 4 panels. After this, I am drawing a layout for each panel, which is, this is meter panel 1. So for meter panel 1, we are using 250 ampere triple pole MCCB, as we have calculated earlier. So this is the main MCCB for meter panel 1. After that, this is the energy meter we are using in the meter panel 1. This energy meter is for 2 BHK. So for 2 BHK we are using MCB of 40 ampere 4 pole and the energy meter is of 5 kilowatt. So 2 BHK, these are 4 numbers, so I am not placing here 4 numbers because of the less space. You can consider 4 branches here. So similarly 3 BHK, 3 numbers, and the circuit breaker we are using for 3 BHK is 50 ampere 4 pole, and for 4 BHK we are using 3 number 4 BHK, and the circuit breaker is 63 ampere 4 pole MCB. Similarly, this one is for common load, which is 200 ampere MCCB triple pole. Thus, here we are using 4 flats into 1, which is the number of floor, 3 flats into 1, which is the number of floor, plus 3 flats into 1, plus common load. So this is how we calculate the total energy meter. So 4 plus 3 plus 3 plus 1 give us a value of energy meter as 11. So we are using 11 energy meters on the meter panel 1. Maximum we can use is 30 energy meter in a single panel. Now moving on to meter panel 2, we are using 400 ampere triple pole MCCB for meter panel 2. This is the branch for 2 BHK. We are using 12 2 BHK, 4 on each floor, so total 12 on 3 floors. So 2 BHK, 12 numbers each floor. You can see we have 4 2 BHK flats, so for 3 floors we have 12 2 BHK flats. So 40 ampere 4 pole MCB is for this 2 BHK, and energy meter is 5 kilowatt. Similarly for 3 BHK we are having 9 numbers, 3 on each floor, so 3 equals to 9. So 50 ampere 4 pole MCCB, 7.5 kilowatt energy meter. For 4 BHK similarly 9 numbers and 63 ampere 4 pole MCCB. So this is the meter panel 2 for our project. Thus we can calculate the energy meter as 4 flats into 3 floor plus 3 flats into 3 floor plus 3 flats into 3 floor. So 12 plus 9 plus 9 is equals to 30 flats. So 30 flats we are using 30 energy meters in meter panel 2, which is maximum we can use in each panel. Thus you can make a note that for every panel we have to use maximum of 30 energy meter. This is the main difference in the designing of high-rise building. So for 2, 3, 4 we are using the meter panel 2, and for 5, 6, 7 this is the meter panel 3, and this is the panel 4 for 8, 9, and 10 floors. Now to make a revision, we are using 800 kVA transformer, then a main LT panel. After that we are using a meter panel 1 for first floor and common load, then meter panel 2 for floor 2, 3, and 4, then meter panel 3 for floors 5, 6, and 7, and meter panel 4 for 8, 9, and 10. Thus we are using different energy meters for meter panel 1, 2, 3 and 4. For meter panel 1 we are using 11, and for 2, 3 and 4 we are using 30 energy meters in total. With this I am done with designing of high-rise building. Hope you people have found this video very useful, and don't forget to like this video to appreciate my hard work, and subscribe to my channel Electrical Infinity. Thanks for watching this video guys, take care.
Where the movie started, facing at a photo they've taken. Space street flying through the skies and petals up on air.